Back to yet another entry in the series, Let Supreme Ghost Thief. Today I've decided to take a little break from the Black Frog, for those of you that follow that playlist, and I've decided to play a Thief Gold mission recently released called Endless Rain. It's released not even 3 weeks ago as I'm recording this. And the reason for that is simple, it's an amazing mission. Such a good mission that I wanted to replay it already. And I thought, why not just make a recording of it and try to Supreme Ghost it? So, if you haven't played this mission, I order you to stop this video right now and download it and play it. Please, I do not want to spoil this experience for anybody. And this is very much a mission where you have to explore and find things on your own. That is half the fun. Or that is most of the fun, actually. If you have played the mission and you're here to stay, welcome. I hope you'll enjoy it. I hope you have whatever snacks you have when you watch my video. I have my beer tonight, because I'm actually recording this at night. And I have my Cheez-Its, and I have Endless Rain, so let's get going. Of course, we're playing an expert. And we have quite a few objectives here. First, find Monsegur's prized opal, Moontear, and redistribute it to yourself. Monsegur's position as Warden of Stone Market and Lower Locks is extremely contested, and he is meticulous and cautious, so his manor is without a shadow of doubt protected. Second, Monsegur must keep some notes on his associates and enemies. See if you can find these. Third, Lord Felton passed away recently and had a priceless ruby in his possession. He doesn't need it anymore, so steal it. Cuddy also told you that one of the wealthiest aristocrats in Stone Market owns a rare pagan relic. Find it and steal it as well. Next, prove you're the best by swiping at least 2,500 worth of valuables tonight. A true professional doesn't leave a mess. Don't kill anyone. And lastly, once you're done, return to where you started. Okay, that sounds like enough trouble for one night, so let's go ahead and get going. There's one more objective that we can find throughout the mission. For those of you not familiar with my videos, I always play videos Supreme Ghosting style. And that's a little bit of a harder mode than regular ghosts. Hopefully you're familiar with that. So we're not allowed to buy anything, for example, for Supreme Ghost. In addition to that, Supreme Ghost prohibits you from using any moss arrows or from dousing any torches. You also can't have any first alerts from guards. That's a big one. That's difficult. You can't trigger any traps. You have to replace everything you use and relock all doors and so forth. But I will explain some details throughout the mission. I always do that. We start with broadhead arrows, 10 of them, 7 water arrows, 5 moss arrows. We can't use any of those. Well, we can use water arrows, but we can't use it to douse torches for Supreme. Lockpick, sword, compass, healing potion, flash bomb, and blackjack. The tip and the gossip here gives you a little bit of information on where you can find certain items. We're not allowed to buy those, and I'm going to show you everything anyway. This mission is possible to Supreme Ghost successfully. We cannot perfect Supreme Ghost it. There is a little bit of loot that we can take, and I'll explain it once we get to it. You can perfect Thief the mission, though. So you can do regular Ghost and get all the loot if you want to. I am not going to do that, but I always show you all the loot, even all the pickable items in the mission. So that's what I'm going to do. Since my last video, there has also been a couple of new releases. Most notably, version 1.22 of New Dark. So I'm playing with that. I think you have to play with that update in order to make this mission work. But there have also been a couple of texture updates, such as the Thief 2 HD pack. This is a Thief 1 mission, so that doesn't apply. But also a mod called the Necro Age mod. A very, very good mod, I think, because it changes some texture into a darker, grittier version of the original low-res textures. And I'm playing with that here. I'm playing with that, I'm playing with Thief Gold HD, and I'm playing with the EP2, or the Enhancement Pack. I know that the readable that Skacky released along with the mission said that he wanted the mission to be played vanilla style, so with all the old resources. I decided to make this recording and play the Supreme version with the new texture updates just because I think it looks better and because I also wanted to showcase those texture packs a little bit. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get started and see where we what we have to do. So I hope that you guys can hear me over the rain. I tried to test this out a little bit before I started. The rain makes a little bit of noise, but not too much. Let me go ahead and make a real save to begin with. And quick save. Okay, let's go ahead and start here. We've got some guards in the initial streets, but I want to read these first. Hereby declared by Burgomaster Hart, with consent from Lord Monsegur, protector of our noble quarter. Let it be known that no beggar nor any other man, woman nor child, may roam the streets after the 11th toll of the bell, under direct consent of the Burgomaster. Any fellow caught wandering the streets without such authorization shall taste the whip accordingly. So that says the same in the top. The good Lord Monsegur, in his undying generosity, offers 500 gold pieces to anyone who would bring the wretched criminals plaguing the borough before him or before an officer of the Baron's police, and offers 100 gold pieces to anyone who would give accurate and verified information on their whereabouts. Know that anyone helping these cowards is as good as dead and shall be harshly punished. Third, in the wake of the recent thefts and other burglaries plaguing our noble borough, let it be known that the Baron's police and the Order of the Hammer have taken drastic measures to eradicate the criminal element crawling within the walls of Stonemarket. Housemasters and mistresses are advised to double the guard on their grounds and close their gates and windows until this affair is dealt with. Okay, wow. Want to head down here first. There's a patch of shadow here. This guard is stationary, and he never moves. Turns a little bit, but he can see anything in front of his little archway. There's also the guard that you saw right there. He comes back. He always does. So we have to be a little bit careful here already. Let me see if I can move here.
I don't see why I should have to be the one down here in the cold and the dark and the damp.
The sound doesn't propagate 100% down here in this plaza, at least. But most of the mission is fine. Ooh, I don't know if we're safe here, actually. We are. See if I can move across here. There's a stationary hammer on that side of the bridge that I want to steal from me as a purse. Actually, let me go ahead and show you guys the map before we get into this. So we start in the south, and actually most of the streets in this mission are more guarded than anywhere else. This is very much a Thieves' Highway type of mission, so it's going to be a lot of vertical movement. I'm going to spend as much as I can of the time up on the rooftops. You have to if we want to get all the loot. This is the street that you see me marking right here. You have Usher Street. You have the bridge that I showed you. Over here is the market. We have the west side of the canal. That is an open plaza. We don't have to go there at all, I think. Then we have Monsegur's Manor in the northwest. That we can get into, and one of our main objectives is found in there. There's a clock tower with a couple of surrounding buildings that doesn't really have a name that you can get into. Fielding Manor, we really can't get into much. A little bit on the north side is where we can enter, but it's really a place that isn't really open. Burrows Estate, there will be another important objective in there, as well as in Felton Manor in the southeast has another objective. Cloister Lane and this plaza we also don't have to enter. And the hammer... I can't really read what that says, but this is a hammer church or some kind of cathedral we can't get into as well. Castle Termay, if that's how it's pronounced, we can't get into it at a couple of different entries. And then we have Usher Palace in the south here. There's also a small little plaza in this area that we can get into with the butcher shop. And that's it. The canal also has a couple of underground sewer entrances that we will venture into at a certain point. But for now, we're gonna cover a little bit of the street area. Okay, this guard is coming back here. It's a little tough to find an open gap in their patrol to head west here. But I'm gonna try to do my best. Once we get off the streets, things will progress fairly rapidly, at least compared to what it's doing right now.
What's there?
Okay, he sees that.
Thought I saw something.
I'm gonna have to wait for him to head back west. So if you hear footsteps but you don't see any guards, there are plenty of patrolling guards up on the balconies. There's one up there, there's one up here. So don't let that fool you. This guard comes back now. Okay, he's too far away to see me, so. So you might notice that the light gem and the health bars are a little bit different. That's because I am using this Necro Age mod
and the builder said
that I really like. I like the look of it.
Whale and natural teeth, you ask it to repair itself. Nay, you tear it down and begin anew. So shall it be with all my children, whether they be stone or flesh.
So this guy has a purse worth 25. And I also just want to read that plaque since I'm here. Stone Market Clock Tower Maintenance. Warning, do not enter. Trespassers will receive the Builder's Righteous Punishment.
Knowledge is our weapon, with which we carve a path to an enlightened future.
They don't understand.
Okay, so we're going to go ahead and head east right now. Follow this guard into this alley.
Hmm.
We have to wait for him to return. He makes a 180 pivot here in the alley. We can't pass him. Yeah, that would come back. Left here, we got to be a little bit careful because there's the patrolling hammer that can see us. We're gonna head in here. This is the weaponsmith's. And pick the lock on that door. Okay, I can hear him coming, so. Okay. All right, in this box we have a stack of gold coins worth 25, total 50. On the counter we have a mine, we have a flash bomb, and we have six broadhead arrows right here. And then we have on top of this cabinet we have two rope arrows. We're only going to need one, so I'm only going to take one. Notice that since I play Supreme, I don't pick up anything that I don't need. I only pick up loot, objectives, and any weapons that I might need that are allowed for that mode. So one rope arrow I will need. Okay, let's go ahead and continue up this way. Here we have a switch, somewhat hidden. Lowers a bookshelf behind us, and we have access to a hidden elevator shaft. Go ahead and I think the lift is at the bottom, so I'm going to click that up. Okay, I'm gonna raise the elevator a little bit. There's a goblin underneath. Worth 25, total 75. So this is a hidden keeper sanctuary of some sort. And there's a few things over here on the table. First of all, there's a shrine key right here. There's a letter, a keeper's message. Keeper Selwyn, please be aware of the fact that we have entrusted Lolf with the protection of the forbidden relic kept deep below the district. It is a very dangerous item that could cause damage beyond imagination were it to fall in the wrong hands. The knowledge it holds must not reach profane minds, and we are sure the creature shall make a fine shield against potential interlopers. I've also entrusted you with a copy of the shrine key in case something goes sour, but use it only for extraordinary cases. And if you do, be ever vigilant of Lolth. Yours in knowledge, Sir Keeper Theobald. So reading that parchment triggers yet another objective. Another keeper trinket, eh? That thing must be quite valuable if it's kept down there. So when you get this objective into your list, of course you have to complete it. It's not an optional objective. And I know for a fact that we cannot complete that objective for Supreme Ghost. We will have to take a bust, multiple busts, in order to complete it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to reload, and I'm not going to read that objective. That prevents it from being in our list, so therefore it also prevents us from having to do it. That is not a bust for Supreme to avoid reading objectives and avoid getting the objective in the list. Back here in this room we have two blue vases, worth 200, total 275. And there's another readable. A keeper's letter. Keeper Selwyn, it is true. I's motives were of dark nature, and such a breach to our doctrine cannot be permitted. He tried to accuse M of the murder of B, but the wise council saw past it and sentenced him. You need not to know what will happen to I afterwards. I know you have doubts concerning our release of both G and M, but rest assured the tomes are purposes for them. A dark age approaches. The medallion disappeared, and I was not able to tell us where it is. We have reasons to believe he hid it somewhere far away from our reach. I am afraid of finding it again is impossible for now. Our acolytes in the Newmarket compound are sure they did not see I entering the shrine after they placed the medallion, and no one was seen entering or leaving the compound before we arrived. In the meantime, the council has assigned you to the Stone Market Sanctuary, and you are to stay here until further notice. The foundations of our ancient order are beginning to shake in the wake of these events, but a great and authoritative spirits such as yourself are the balance our noble organization needs in such dire times. The state of dismay our order traverses is more grave indeed, but I have absolute reasons to believe this will change very soon. Yours in knowledge, Keeper Artemis. Okay, so I'm going to reload as well, so that I leave that scroll where it was. Okay. So, again, I'm leaving the key there, because I don't need it for Supreme. But once we get to it, I will still show you how to get that objective fulfilled. Okay, now for Supreme, like I said, we have to reset everything. So I'm going to lower this lift. And I'm going to close the secret entrance. There we go. Okay, now we have what we need. We absolutely need a rope arrow. Alright, so some of you might think that since I'm headed east, I might as well just go ahead and enter Felton Manor, which you can do through a pickable door right here. I'm not going to do that, because even though it's not in the Supreme Rules, I like to minimize the amount of locks picked. Most locks that are pickable cannot be relocked, and I feel that's a little bit of the Supreme spirit, at least, is to make sure that you change as little as possible, except for loot and objectives. So I know that we can get through this mission only picking three locks. There are plenty more that are pickable, but I'm going to try to minimize that. So instead I'm going to use my rope arrow and get up to the rooftops in a different manner. Okay, I'm going to shoot a rope arrow into here. That was too high. You can shoot it so you can reach it from below, but also mantle up on the pipe up there. This is what I want to do. I know that guard is there, but I just wanted to see if I can reach it. You know what, I'm going to go ahead and make a real save here so that we can experiment a little bit. That looks pretty good to me. It's got to be pretty far out from the wall, which it seems like it is. Oh! That guy's facing away, that's good. There we go. Now we gotta be a little bit aware of the guard that's in this yard right here. We'll mantle up the statue. All the way to the east, the inner side of it is dark. So there we go. So I said we were to mantle up the pipe, it's easier to mantle up this statue actually. Okay, we're gonna head over here and we're gonna walk that pipe over to the other end. Getting on top of these pipes without making noise is a little bit difficult at times. So here's another guard. You can spot a window open between those two statues. We're gonna head there as well. End of this pipe, there are two wooden shutters that we can open. We can mantle in here as well. This is what I just love about this mission. There are these hidden rooms found everywhere, and you can't always tell whether the windows are openable or not. In here we find a silver coin stack worth 12 and a gold coin stack worth 25 for a total of 312. There are also two moss arrows on top of this cabinet. And there's a readable over here. Now don't you dare say you don't see these damn leaks in Junction 18. Yes, you dimwit taffer. That's the one that goes right under the canal crossing Usher Street, and the one I've been telling you have been needing repairs for months now. There's knee-high water in there. I had to lock the machine room so the machines wouldn't get damaged. If you don't move your lazy quill pusher bum to get it repaired as soon as possible, you'll get the whole Stonemarket Public Works Division flooded in no time. So I assume this is some kind of janitor's office. And the janitor has a hidden vent behind these crates, so we're going to have to move the crates for the time being. There. Open the vent. Head inside. This is another house. We can't really go into any other rooms, but there are two gold goblets worth 25 each, and there is a bottle of wine worth 50, total 412. And we can head back. There. That's good enough. Okay. So there's a guard that patrols this balcony. We want him to pass us so that we can head into that door. See, I think we can wait here. Yes, we could. Good. So this is a control room of some sort. There's another letter here, and a flash bomb on the table. 3 months. I've been employed here for 3 months, and it's the only time these Taffin gears there on the wall have stopped. The noise they made was so painful I couldn't make it disappear from my head. But now that it has stopped, it's even worse. I hope that nutbag of a mechanician will come to repair them soon. I still prefer to hear the real noise than a phantom sound ringing in my head. Okay, and next to this electrical coil, we have 2 stacks of silver coins and 1 stack of copper coins for a total of 441. So we have to dodge that guy coming back. And
what's there?
He's on his way back right now. I don't think there's a way to hide in that room. So up here for now. There's nothing of interest up here. There's just a door that's pickable. But like I said earlier, I don't like to pick doors if I don't have to. This lever is not operative. Since this is a Thief Gold mission, by the way, enemies don't detect doors opening or closing or lock picking, for example, as easily as they would in Thief 2. That we don't want. It's a little difficult to get onto these chains without making that clunky noise. You can sort of get on the edge, the invisible edge. Like that. And then get on top of them. And this chain is dark for part of the way, at least. Can mantle up this pipe. And then we can wait for that patrolling archer right here. Should be a good way of doing it. There we go. So this is the top floor of the fishmongers. And there's a blue base, and that's not it, because this bottle is worth 50 as well. Total of 541. Okay, heading upstairs. Let's do this instead. Okay, in here there's nothing of value except there's a window that we can leave through. Excuse me. We're gonna do that, and then we're gonna head to the opposite side here. I actually jump, that would be better. Good. We're gonna head southwest and then around the corner here. The guards in the streets on this side can't really see you that well. Because you're too far up. If you're directly above guards, they have a difficult time seeing you. Plus, part of the way is dark. Go. Reach this balcony, and that gutter is climbable as you saw. And now we have to make a little nifty move here. We have to jump over to that ledge. Not that difficult because you can mantle pretty easily. There we go. Good. If you head around this corner, on this ledge, there's a purse, and that purse is worth 10. And then there are 3 stacks of copper coins worth 5 each, total 15. Grand total of 566 now. Just short of 2 grand away from our loot goal. Normally, I would be careful saving in this kind of a position, but that guard is so far below me. So he saw me once I mantled up the balcony, so I'm gonna have to wait for him. I'm gonna wait for this guard to come back up and leave.
Who's there?
Oh wow, he sees me through the couch. That's what he did. Close the door. We gotta head over here. We gotta grab 2 pieces of loot in the living room. 2 vases worth 100 each. Total 766. And then we have a stack of copper coins, 3 of them. And this readable. 815.33, 270 Tarki, 400 Rimley, 320 Gray, 432 is Sengrin, or Isengrin, 1750 Monsegur, and 460 Dario. 822 33, 320 Gray, 2200 Brosius, 1750 Monsegur, and 460 Dario. I cannot afford to lose any more money. The amount I must refund is astonishing, and Monsegur's toll is way too harsh. It was a bad idea going to the Overlord's fancy with finances so low. I should consider selling some of my trinkets or something, otherwise I'm a dead man. Okay. Okay, we don't have time to get all of that before he returns. Oh, this isn't even tiles, so we have no problem doing it then. Down here, there's nothing of real value except for the exit point, which is found in the toilet. Or restroom, to be politically correct. And that takes us out on the north side balcony. This is a cozy little area, too. A real save, I think. Okay. Next, we're gonna head into this tower. I'm gonna have to shoot a rope in there. Watch around for guards. There's one, for example. He will guaranteed see us jumping. Grab the rope and head into this window right here. On this windowsill, you have two more rope. No, moss arrows. Behind this painting, we have two blue vases worth 50 each, total 881. Okay, straight across the street is the power station. There's a guard in there that we gotta be careful of. Now, I have not found a good way of getting onto this pipe without making noise, so I usually make a leap directly for the window or for the statue above. Okay. Statue above is okay as well. Then you can drop down here. We want to wait for him to pass again. He has a pretty short patrol in there. See, I'm not sure if we're concealed. Yes, we are. Okay, if you mantle up the... whatever this is.
Hello?
Gotta be a little bit more careful than that. His patrol isn't that difficult, but...
Sir?
Okay, we are dark on top of that boiler, so...
What there?
Ay, 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 ay.
Hello?
Okay, let me wait for him to come back again. Up here you have 3 stacks of copper coins worth 15. Total 896. Okay, let's wait for him again.
Hello?
Too eager, too eager. Guess that's a good sign.
What's there? Hello?
Oh my goodness. Oof.
Hello?
He can see through that machine too. Okay. Alright, alright, alright.
What's there? Hello?
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Let's drop down here then. How come this is so difficult? I didn't have any problems with this guy before. Here. Finally. Here we're safe. I think he can hear the elevator, but... There's a zombie down here. It's the only zombie in the mission. And there's a piece of loot right behind where he is right now. A silver nugget, and here are 3 broadhead arrows, if you like picking up all the weapons and items. Okay, I can hear that he just came and turned around, so I have to open this door when he is away.
Who's there?
So he has to be even further away than that. Okay.
What's there?
Oh. Okay.
rock in the damp.
Oh, how he saw me when he walked sideways.
Sir? Sir?
Yeah, he sees me. Just wait over here again. So also here, you have to sort of mantle up instead of landing on the pipe. There. Here we go. We could have continued in the basement of the power station and come out in the sewers, but there you also have to pick the lock on a door, and that's not necessary. So I'd like to avoid it. Okay, here. Can actually... Nobody should hear that. I didn't hear any alerts, at least. Up here's a gas arrow. If you're looking for all the weapons. Kind of inch your way down this roof. I like to actually drop on top of this lamp and save there. Now we're gonna have to make our way through a little bit of a difficult move again to this balcony right here. Wow, I found a dark spot right here. You can do it from this fence post, but I find it easier from that one. Let's wait for this archer to go away. I want to wait for him to come back out so that I have a maximum amount of time. There are two goblets and one bottle of wine on the balcony fence. I'll grab that and then head inside once he leaves. Sometimes he stands there for a little bit, sometimes he just pivots and goes back inside. go. Oh, I didn't want to pick up that stupid plant. I'm not looking to collect plants.
Sir?
Oh, he was there. I thought he was over on the left-hand side. Okay, then we have plenty of time. It would be beneficial to jump. Oh, somebody saw me there. Did you hear that? Did that dude see me?
When are they going to bring me my dinner?
I think he might have. That guy sees me. Did he not see me earlier? That's crazy. I didn't even notice any alerts from him earlier. Might just have to wait him another cycle to be able to do this properly. I hope that will work. And now he comes back. Can you believe this? I might actually have just missed or like overlooked his alert there earlier. If I wait a second, I don't think I get his alert. I can still hear it. Clearly. Okay, I'm gonna have to wait a little bit more. This is a difficult move, so. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to wait for that archer to leave again. Oh well. That's what half of Supreme Ghosting is all about, waiting. See, hopefully we'll be able to do it now. And there we have a vase. Total 1126.
Sir?
All right. I'm going to have to be a little bit quicker. I was just going to check to see if that archer was there, or she wasn't. I'm going to go ahead and make a real save here, actually.
Sir? Who's there?
You can actually jump back up there. That's what I want to do. I don't want to jump into the sewers. Or into the canal, sorry. You can do this. You have to get more of an angle than that. This is going to take a little bit of repeating. So if it takes a long time, I'll go ahead and annotate. Getting closer. There we go. Good. Yeah, the archer is on his way back. Good, we missed him too. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right, so we should have a total of 1126 now. Yep, that's correct. That's where we're at. Okay, now we're going to spend a little bit of time on the streets. We have to hit one establishment before we get back up to the rooftops.
Nothing making noise.
Ooh, he didn't even give a first alert. It's a little bit tricky to get to the apothecary, which is where we're going to go next. It's down where you see that street sign, down to the right of that guard. There are a few places where we can hide, but there's another guard there as well, as you see. And then that archer comes as well.
Did that shadow move?
Here's dark. It's not dark here. It's not dark here. Okay. Well, we have to get there, somehow. There's loot in there, so we can't skip that store.
And the people up above me get all the light and get all the favors, and I don't have another thing to eat in days. Hmm. don't see why I should have to be the one down here in the cold and the dark and the damp.
Great. Good, okay. There's a guard that should come out from the left, and then we can head in to the store. Yep. Here we go. Ralph Downer, apothecary. So, a drugstore, chemist, whatever you want to call it. Okay. In here, we have a speed potion, 3 water arrows, and there's a single moss arrow. There's 1 holy water vial, which if you play regular Ghost and when you want to get all the objectives and all the loot, you will have to take 1 holy water vial. And there's another vial behind the bottom of the bookshelf. And then in this stack, in this box, there are gold coins, a stack of them, worth 25, total 1151. Quickly want to head back up here. That's annoying when that happens. Sometimes those beams that stick out are not that easy to mantle for some reason. It's easier this time. It was. Good. Now we're going to head north. Northeast. So we've now covered most of the west part of town. We've not been to Monsegur's, the Wardens, of course. And we've not done the sewers. And we just moved along this ridge. So we're going to head into the area above the canal. And then start moving our way east. Make another reel set here. Okay, there's a guard inside that building through those windows, so we've got to be a little careful about him. Okay, there are no guards in this
building.
Oh, I hate those. So difficult to drop down from the windows here without making any noise.
Hello? Show yourself.
Okay, now he saw me through those windows, so you got to hear him at least. Plenty of guards around. At least nobody was around to hear it. Okay, this is a gallery. This is Cribb's gallery from Song of the Caverns and Thief Gold, if you remember him. There's a gold candlestick, total 1201, and there's a letter. A letter from Lady Valerius It's great to see her back. Mr. Cribbs, it is with great pleasure that I write this letter, and I hope you will receive it on due time. I have finally acquired the old quarter opera house from this nuisance and kicked him out with my newly acquired guard. Captain Collier knows how to do his work, but I digress. I'm writing this message with the intent of offering you my previous position. Yes, I want you to become the new director of music for the opera. I'm absolutely sure that your music will mesmerize our guests of exceptional status, and your presence within the opera will be a constant delight. Together we shall change the face of music, Lady Valerius. All right. I love much of the readables in this mission is keeping the story of Thief Gold intact. It's a nice bit of continuity. Let's head out this window now on the north side. Let's drop down to the ledge. I'm going to make a quick peek around this corner. On the ledge there in the window on the left, you see a speed potion. If you are, again, interested in collecting all the items. In the meantime, be wary of that archer. We have to head over here. So we're now crossing the canal to the north side. We're not going to stay there for long. There's nothing on the east side of this ledge. But around here there is. Gonna wait for that guard to go away. These pipes are a nuisance. There. On this table is a bottle of wine, total 1251, and then there's yet another readable. I, Sir Thomas William Maxwell, honest proprietor of this fine house in our most esteemed Stonemarket district, hereby declare the monthly canal card game open, in which participants will fight to the very death in the manner of speaking. Winners shall drink and woo lasses, and losers shall plunge into the canal below and be mocked. Place your bets now. Participants, Sir Thomas William Maxwell, Bartholomew McCarrigal, Count Drakengold, Turnip Willie Balders, and Sir Percy Percy. My goodness. Whew. Okay, up here are a few things worth noting at least. No valuables. I'm just gonna show you that anyway. Through this vent. On top of this cabinet, you have five water arrows. No, five broadhead arrows, not water. And if we follow this guard. On the table right here is a key. It's a cloister key. You won't need that until much later, to get into Monsegur's house. If you desire to go into his house by the way of the canal. I don't. I'm going to head into his place a little bit of a different route. This mission is so beautiful, I gotta tell you. The architecture, the design, the textures, even without the HD graphics, it's still a beautiful mission. The lighting and the rain, smoke, fog, all that combined, perfect. Okay, now we're gonna head east. I'm gonna make another reel save once I have that possibility too. We're getting into some dicey situations.
Someone making.
Oh.
The guard you hear right now is downstairs. Okay. So, there's no loot in the bedroom here, but out that door there are a couple of pieces of loot. I'm not going to save it here because if you save on a ladder, you fall down when you reload. And there's a stationary guard out there, you can see. Save here. In this room, though, there's a healing potion. There are, I think, 5 broadheads in this chest. And then there's another letter. Merlin, I'm telling you again that even if we do business with Monsegur, playing their game is more trouble than it's worth. I'm sure you remember Albertram, that poor bugger from Lowreach, who got a nice beating from Reputo's leg breakers the other day. Do you want to end up like him? I don't think so. He was lucky to end up with only 4 missing fingers and his right arm broken to pieces. But this won't happen next time. Keep doing your job, and don't ask questions. The fact that DeWall was betrayed by one of his own clearly shows how these city wardens operate. They're just a bunch of low lives, but they are powerful and dangerous. You should stay away from their business if you know what's good for you. Cedric. P.S. Whatever you do, just stay away from Newmarket. Reputo's tough boys seem to be very twitchy lately for some reason. Could be because of Messer Beric's death. Apparently they fished his corpse in the canal near Widow's Way the other day in Azamlarg's territory. This won't appease tensions. Okay, I think that's it. Yep.
Thought I saw something.
So this is going to be a little difficult. We have to head out there and get into a shadow of some sort. Before that guard returns. This is good. And we're not supposed to make noise. We can't mantle the table, so that's what I'm going to do. There are 3 coin stacks out there.
There.
He can't turn west like he did now. If he does that, we will get caught.
Ahem.
the guard inside sees us also.
And the people up above me get all the light and get all the favors and night on that. Must have been imagining things.
Oh.
Hello?
I don't remember that guard inside being a problem last time. That guard is a problem, the outside one. You're in bright light pretty much all the time from the door down to the table. Stacks of silver coins and one stack of copper coins, total 1280. And we have to leave as well. Also, now he can't turn west. If he does, we are caught. Great. Now we have to dodge another guard down here. He's not that difficult to get by. The top floor is by far the difficult one. Oh. And I didn't save it because I didn't want to save it in the... I didn't want to save it in the ladder. That's okay. This isn't that difficult. It's just a matter of waiting for that guard to not face west. There he is. You wait here, he's gonna come out here, turn around, and go back. Then we can follow him. Safe here. Two stacks of copper coins, total 1290, and this letter. You remember when Webster's tough boys said they wanted to take over Lower Locks? Looks like they've set their plan in motion, if you ask me. They want to wear the boss down here so they can freely operate in Lower Locks. I told you I saw these guys use grappling hooks and other stuff to climb sheer heights. Stone Market seemed to be the perfect playground for them with all these towering spires and high walls. I get all dizzy when I have to watch over the parapets and all, and the captain I have is less than amazing. Remember that Taffer Darren? That's right, he's my captain now. For some reason he climbed hierarchy. That guy is so disrespectful and won't hear me out when I say that these thieves are just a distraction. Do your job and shut your taffin mouth, he says. Never listens to anybody but himself. Say a word again and I stick my sword up your belching throat, he says again. I think a little trip over the walls to the street below will soften his attitude. I know that would work for me, Ethan. Okay. Up here is a vent that you can actually open, but you can't reach the ladder above it from below, unless you have a couple of crates, I guess. So that really is only a one-way ticket if you come down it. And then downstairs, all there is a door that you can pick to get out into the streets, or actually out to the canal. I am not interested in picking any locks, as you know by now. So I'm not going to do that.
Someone behind.
Okay, I can probably head in there before he comes, if I'm a little bit quicker. Hey, that was intentional, by the way. It did not fall there. But I just wanted to do it quickly before that guard came back from outside. Okay, so now we're done with all the buildings on the west side of the canal, except for Monsegur, which we'll get from the east side. We'll go through this way. And the sewers. And the sewers is what I'm going to cover next. Make a real save right here. So I'm gonna make a quick save and then I'm gonna take a little trip over to the sewer control room. If you wanna rob Monsegur, there's a ladder in the distance and a door on the left. There's also a rope that hangs down from the ceiling. I don't know if you can see that beyond that light. That takes you up. The rope takes you up into Monsegur's well in his front yard. The door on the left takes you into the butler's room. But there's a third way in that I'm going to take. But if you want to get through here, you have to first pick the lock on this door. Head up these, or this ladder. Here you see a control switch. You flip that, it will raise the portcullis for the sewer. Waterway portcullis control. There's one lone guard in here. I think these doors are both pickable. This is a pickable one as well. In this room, on the table on the far end there is a flash bomb. That's pretty much all of interest in here. You can't leave that bedroom in any other way. So I'm not interested in that area. I don't need to go in there, so I'm going to head into the sewers instead. This door is pickable. That actually takes us to the bottom floor of the power station where the zombie was. This takes us to the sewer control room. It's up here a ways. is. This guard has a purse worth 5. Total 1295. We can follow him into the main control room. Dodge him in some fancy ways. He walks around this pillar. On this table, you have a loaf. And there's a readable. Shane, have you ever wondered what lied behind that huge portcullis? I've searched around for a lock, but haven't found anything. And I've tried to force it open with one of them fancy steam cranks the mechanicians from downtown tinker, but no dice. The thing's shut tight and staff and heavy. These sewers are so old that the area isn't even in the official records. The place is still lit, though, so it must be on the same power grid as the Stone Market Public Works Division. There's probably some tomb or another behind that gate. And I bet your month's pay there's bound to be something valuable down there, Jace. I thought there was a healing potion around here somewhere. Yeah, there it is. Oops, I'm sure that he saw me there. So we're gonna head into this area and drop in. It takes us to another previously inaccessible area. Okay, we're gonna head up here. Here we have 2 stacks of silver coins and 1 stack of copper coins, total 1324. Let's read this book. 8-12-33. Received a gold vase from Joth. He told me he got it from Newmarket when they intercepted cargo destined to the Tyrell Estate or something. That was pretty nice, and it looks good on my new fancy desk. What a pain dragging it down the staircase, but it was worth it, that's for sure. Old Nate has a fancy desk now. 8-16-33. Simon sent me a letter full of anger today. I sent him the items I got from the guys down in the stinkers, as usual, but he sent them back in a package and told me not to deliver stuff to his cache anymore, because the Hamrites are giving him trouble. Who does he think he is? Now I am risking my neck with that gold vase and the other stuff the boys got me previously? 8-19-33. The Hamrites decided to come to my shop, looking for the people helping these bastards operating within our turf, and I was terrified the whole time. They asked me questions with such a tone that I couldn't resist wetting my pants in fear. They finally left after a while. I'm ashamed to admit it, but the thought of rotting in Cragsleft is enough to send shivers down my spine. Fortunately for me, they didn't visit the basement, otherwise I couldn't write this. The vase that he's talking about is under his desk, worth 100, total 1424. It's another letter in his waste bin. No, I told you again that until these outsiders are dealt with and the hammer stop patrolling my streets, no one is to deliver stuff to my cache. It is already hard enough with the hammers, but now they are ready to smite more people and send them directly to Cragsleft. If we can get caught, there's no way we'll get refunds for the protection fee. We'll end up on the gallows like that taffer who got caught the other day. And you'll be damned if you don't get hanged, Simon. So the guy that you saw earlier is Nate, and he has the key to his store.
What the hell are you doing here?
There. If you head up into his store, there's basically nothing there, except for 3 apples, 4 cucumbers, and 2 carrots. That's it. So we don't really need any of that. You can also exit the store using the key that he carries. You actually come out right where you started the mission. Instead, let's head in here. This is the hidden thieves' cache, the thieves' guild. And there's one patrolling thief that I want to avoid. He's pretty easy to avoid.
Freeze!
Oh, whoa. Easy to avoid, I say. Okay, here we have a blue vase, a green vase, we have a flash bomb, we have two rope arrows, I think.
Yeah. People around here, I don't care.
Two goblets, a stack of gold coins, two stacks of silver coins, and two stacks of copper coins, and a pair of glasses. Over here we have three water arrows, and we have a letter. Did you hear the news? After Jihan, if that's how you pronounce it, Jihan, fell to his death and Finley got caught, Adolfo decided to leave the boss and he's thinking of going independent. He told me he's going to the Bone Hoard to steal some gemstone or another, and that he's been thinking of doing it for a long time. He even asked me to go with him, but I said no way. He's completely insane. Nobody ever came back alive from that God's forsaken place, and if Webster learns that, his wrath will be terrible. We better continue to plunder Stone Market good if we want to avoid his anger. But without Adolfo's talents, this will be hard. Rajan. This is actually pretty cool, because Adolfo is one of the people that went after the Mystic Heart or the Mystic Soul, one of those two, in the Bone Horde. You can find Adolfo actually pretty early on in the Bone Horde. It's in one of the upper vaults. So this is, again, nice piece of continuity from Skacky, the author. I like that. This is a half-open door, but you can't open it any further, so there's no way to exit here. You have to go back into the servers. Okay, he heard that. I don't know if he saw me, but I don't want to take any chances. Yeah, he didn't hear that, for sure. Okay, now we can head back. This is the entrance to the Keeper Vaults, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a real save here, and I'm actually going to load a previously made save that I have for regular ghosts. We had 1663 in loot, and I just want to show you that I have 1663. I have exactly the same, except I have taken the Keeper Shrine key, and I have also read the Keeper note, which gave me the objective of finding the Keeper trinket. I have also taken a holy water vial from the apothecary. Now, in order to open these portcullis, which that letter talked about, you have to flip the switch behind this statue right here. That you have to close afterwards. Well, no, because this is now we're playing for regular ghosts. The plaque on the wall here says, "Ye who seek entry must cleanse my heart first." So that means that we have to shoot a holy water arrow on this statue. That opens the...
Who's there?
Well, I don't...
Hello?
...care about first alerts now, because I'm...
Just the wind, I guess.
...regular ghosts. I'm just wanting to show you this, really. I'm not gonna... I'm obviously gonna reload later. This is Lulf, the huge spider that was talked about in the Keeper notes in their sanctuary. So she is keeping their relic safe, or their trinket, with a few victims. There are also a couple of victims that hangs from the ceiling in the distance. I don't know if you can see that. You can Supreme Ghost through this area, no problem. There. Here. Here's a dead thief. I can't remember his name. I think maybe this is Rasky or something. I'm not 100% sure, but I think one of the later readables talk about him. There's a rope arrow next to him, and then there's a letter. This is over. In my quest... This is Rasky, yes. This is over. In my quest for wealth and glory, I entered this forsaken and isolated place on a stupid impulse, and now here I am, poisoned and wounded by that nameless horror in the cave. I was ill-prepared, and I am paying the price for my mistake. To think I was so close, so close! The treasure is just there, but all my strength has faded away. I cannot move my legs, and I can barely scribble this with my shaking hands. I dare not think of what will become of me. Rasky. Okay. And here we have all the loot that we have to skip for Supreme Ghost. First of all, there is a tiara worth 125. There are three artifacts worth a total of 60, and there's a statue worth 75. Total 260 loot. All that we have to skip for Supreme Ghosts. And in here we have the objective. Let's go ahead and open this door with the Keeper Shrine key. Also be aware there...
This looks interesting.
Yes, it does, Garrett. Here we have a gas mine. We can easily go past it, but if you don't know about it, it's obviously easy to set it off. You can actually... What I thought about, because this taking the objective will trigger a trap that makes a lot of noise, that can alert the spider outside. So I tried to lock the door and run inside, but then you actually are... trapped. So don't do that. So if you stand, I would say right about here. Should be good. So this is the Seven Forbidden Doctrines. Okay. So he did hear that. Oh, okay. Well, that was it. That completed the objective. You can do it if you time it right. And not actually have the spider alert at all if he's at the other end of the cave. That's just a matter of... luck, I guess. So we cannot head down there for two reasons. Well, one reason why we can't head down there. We can't use a holy water vial. That's not allowed. We gotta head back up here now. No, we do not. Not this way. We cannot use a holy water vial. That goes against Supreme rules. Supreme Rule number 5 says that you cannot use any potions, and a holy water vial is a potion. So that's why you have to skip all the loot. Goodness gracious. And you can't take the seven forbidden doctrines because that sets off a trap, which also is not allowed. According to rule number 9 of the Supreme Ghost rules. So 260 loot skipped is okay. I'd rather do that than actually bust Supreme. So now we're back in the canal, and now we can continue through the city. So we haven't actually completed any objectives yet, but that's because most of the objectives are on the north or east side of town, and those are not the parts that we have covered yet. Okay. So now, first I want to hide in here. What was that? Man, seems like I'm getting stuck here for some reason. Okay. Well, I want to shoot a rope arrow up here anyway. And you're dark sort of halfway through. I want to wait for this archer to come by. You can see his head right there. And I want him to turn around. We're now right here. So we're going to cover Castle Termay. And we're going to go loot Monsegur's afterwards. Okay, a little difficult to find shade. Anyhow. Head in here for now. Head upstairs.
This door. Who is there?
It's Garrett. Who are you? Okay, on the table here are two blue vases. Total 1763. This card also has a purse, and that purse is worth 25, total 1788. That's it, nothing else. There is a window open that you can actually leave through or get in through if you so desire. I want to wait for this archer to come back. Hide here, but you can also hide over here, which is a little bit better. I want to head over to the other side of this chain. Should be a couple of guards in the streets, but I can't see them.
Hello? Show yourself.
There he is. Okay. Might have to.
Hello?
You're supposed to be able to mantle into that windowsill. But that is difficult. But that's what I want to do, because I'm pretty lit up there. One stack of copper coins, one stack of gold coins. Total 1818. Oh. There's not much in it, but that windowsill is dark, or darker. And I don't want to save here either. Great Scott.
Who's there?
Well, I mean, I might be able to... I can try just waiting over there.
I heard that.
I didn't anticipate this to be that difficult. There. Oh. It doesn't he's so far away that it doesn't look like his patrol triggers until I actually look at him. Sometimes that happens. Okay, so anyway, now I'm safe. I got the coins and I'm good to go. Oh, he sees that little tiny speed enhancement. Well, I know there's a lot of reloading here, but you guys are getting the raw footage. I don't leave anything out when I play. So... you get what you get in my videos. Take it or leave it. We want to head through here. And all the way to the back wall, there should be enough shade for us to avoid any visual alerts from any of the guards. It's really only the archer here that is worrisome right now. The other guys are way too far below. Okay, I wanna head up like that. There. Wanna head over there. Then I wanna jump back onto this rope, because I want to get the goblet in this windowsill.
No, he stopped.
Yeah, okay, he did see me there. I can be a little bit quicker, I know. A little bit too quick. Yeah. He definitely did not see me there. He wasn't even through the doorway when I was up here. Good. You can actually drop directly into this window.
Is that you?
It's very difficult, but you can. That way you don't have to leave the rope arrow there. Well, you can maybe retrieve it. There you go. Ooh, that was loud. That was too loud for comfort, for my sake. I don't know if I got an alert in the streets there. Especially since this mission is Supreme Ghostable. Well, I hear him pretty easily when he does give an alert, so... I don't know. Whoa. That he heard. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and use a rope arrow. I think I should be able to. Oh, yeah, totally. Good. Okay. This is the top floor of the Diamond Cutters. Here's a dead body and a letter. This is your last warning. Either you hand that gemstone over or you die. You know who. Okay. So where's the gemstone? Well, it's up here. It's a simple diamond. Total 1943. If we go downstairs, we're going to head out the window, but... we'll head downstairs. On the back wall here is the key to the front door. Here's a gold vase, worth 100, not gold vase, but a blue vase. Total 2043. There's nothing else of interest down there. That was probably the Diamond Cutter himself. Alright, I'm gonna make a real save right here. Because now we're entering Monsegur's, and this is going to be the most difficult place in the mission. Yeah, in the entire mission, basically. There's a couple of other areas that are a little bit tricky, but not overall. Especially Monsegur's bedroom himself. So we've pretty much been able to move all the way from Wailing Way to Monsegur's only through balconies and rooftops and windows, which is pretty awesome. This entire mission, I would say 80 to 90% of it, is all up in the heights. On the rooftops, through windows, you know, rope arrow climbing, pipe maneuvering and balancing. It's just awesome. Just plain awesome. This is what I imagine being a real thief in that day and age would actually feel like. Okay, we gotta wait for that guard. This is a tricky room. Yeah, we gotta wait for him. There are a couple of pieces of loot in here, but I'm gonna wait with those because we have to leave through this window also. There's a door over by the vase in the background there on the right, on the north wall. So I have to be a little bit quick. Creep Crouch running. Now I'm moving over to Creep Crouch strafing because he turned around. Running again and then strafing once he turns. There it is. There isn't much in it, but we did it regardless. Okay, this is the sitting room. There's one guard that patrols through here, but there are some areas of darkness. There are two goblets worth 25 each and a bottle worth 50. And there are two candlesticks worth 50 each on the mantelpiece, total 22.43. I want to wait for that guard to head through here. There's another guard also, or not a guard, but a servant, the butler, that maneuvers through this room, but I should be able to avoid him if I head over here. There's the guard that we just saw. He makes a loop. And there's the butler, and there's an archer in the background as well. Those are the only three guards that, or three enemies that are on this floor. Okay, there's a gold candlestick worth 50 in here. Total 22.93. And I want to head down into the butler's quarter. Which I believe is in here. Yeah. And there should also be a letter in here. A butler's letter. Kevel, how thrilling it must be to work for someone such as Lord Monsegur. My master, Lord Baffert, is an insufferable and dim taffer, and working as his butler is the worst torture you could possibly imagine. Why, just yesterday I went to the annual Butlers of the City meeting, and, like last year's edition and the years before, I won the Who Has the Stupidest Master contest again, by a large margin. If it weren't for the South Quarter pubs, I would have sent my resignation letter a while ago. Oh well, I just hope you're fine. I miss our evening spent drinking. Marcus. Another nice little piece of information from Thief Gold. I really enjoy that about this mission. Not sure if the butler comes in here. He might. Read this. To all servants, make sure to clean the ballroom and the main hall. I don't want to see dust or any scurrying animals for the next reception. Clean the dishes and polish the vases as well. And tell that lackward mate to stop moving the furniture in my chambers around. This also goes for the plants in the library. I don't want anyone near those. I also want to bring another matter to your attention. I misplaced my signet ring somewhere in the house and can't find it. I was reading a book when I noticed I had lost it. Find it. Lord Monsegur. Okay, let's go ahead and find that key for him. Let's wait over here until the butler returns.
Someone make it.
Oops, pressed the wrong key there. This is the library, but we're gonna head into the foyer, the staircase room. Vase. 200, 25,
18. Who's there?
Oh, I thought it was darker in here.
Is someone there?
Okay. Here is the Lord's Ring. Total 26-18. Now, his readable also mentioned something about the plants. These are the plants he meant. He meant not to move them because there is a hidden switch in there. It opens the ceiling panel that we are supposed to climb up. There we go. Grab the rope, we're going to close it on our way down. And here we have a back room to Monsegur's bedroom, which is right beyond that wall. Okay, we have a rope arrow, we have a cloister key. We don't need any of those. And then we have Monsegur's notes. Burrows, old magistrate family. Current head of household is Melchett Burrows, judge. Ties to paganism and Larlock society, whatever that is. He's my lieutenant, but even if he excels at what he does, I fear he may have warden aspirations himself, seeing how Azamlarg is a warden and magistrate herself. I must watch him closely. Kelvin Hart, current burgomaster of Stonemarket. They're an old but penniless family nowadays. I'm certain the fat old man is using the money I give him to protect my subjects for drinks and whores. Replace him as fast as possible. Felton, old spice merchant family. The young but naive lady is a sight to behold, and I have invited her many times to share my company. The old bastard died, undoubtedly assassinated by Eleanor. She does whatever I tell her to do, but Lord Felton's death is something that makes me uneasy, and that wasn't planned. He was my direct connection to Blackbrook, thanks to his friendship with Dorcas Goodfellow. And I doubt Eleanor has any deep knowledge about that. A shame, because the only other person with close ties to Goodfellow I know is a thief's pawn named Victoria, and she doesn't want to work for anyone. Messer Beric, ha! And here I thought this miscreant would be working for Reputo. Looks like the booger got fished in dark smoke, and word is Reputo is looking for some thug called Garrett, who reputedly killed the guy. Garrett, I've heard this name before, but when? Dorian, another penniless merchant. He had a huge fortune, but wasted it all, and now can't keep up with the taxes. Too bad for him. If he doesn't pay soon, his head will roll. He's too much of a risk to keep around a month more. Who knows what he may tell the Hamrites under pressure. The Combine has been weakened because of this, and I'm in a fragile position. Weldon, McAllister, and Usher are all loyal to the operation and keep paying me regularly. I may throw a party soon and invite other nobles. I've had my eyes on Duchess Kurinov for a while. So this actually checks off finding Monsegur's notes on his associates and enemies. And we've also reached the 2,500 loot requirement, so we're good there. There's another letter in here, though. Old Quarter. Fines Legbreakers. Main base of operations. Illegal trade, protection and anti-protection. Bribes, illegal bear fights. Very dangerous. No contact with R. Numerous Hamrite patrols. Lots of watchers on the parapets and the rooftops. Sybil Manor. Heavily protected house, but probably easy access through the balcony. Back garden, but getting there might prove difficult. Guards seem organized. Alois almost got caught while scouting the area. Too dangerous for now. Dark Hollow. Cat house within downtown. Supposed location of the Chalice of Souls. Very difficult access. Very old building. As old as the city, probably. We'll have to investigate more. Brosius Estate. Posh mansion located in dark smoke. Very easy access with lots of open windows. Guards are organized, though. We'll have to send my dog's bodies to snoop around some more to find the perfect access. Sutter can probably climb there, but if they raid the place, they can't risk being recognized in the streets. Okay, so lots of good information here about other parts of town that we can't get to, so maybe that's all for an upcoming mission, who knows. Flip the switch. This is Monsegur's bedroom. Now this could get difficult. Let's get our bearings here. All right. In the northwest corner, there is a balcony. And he is stationed there for quite some time. He's also stationed over where you saw him, which is where his safe is. He's stationed over by his desk. And he makes a little pivot right over here. You can see right now. I'm going to go ahead and steal his key. There we go.
I could have sworn that shadow moved.
Okay, so you could. Stand a little bit further back this time. Thank you. Here he comes. There we go.
Hey, what was that?
So I want to head over to the southwest corner. That's a good place to wait. Here's a vase, 27-18 total. Here's a gold candlestick and four stacks of gold coins, total 28-68. Here's Monsegur's diary. 8-16-33, 2 weeks. It's been 2 weeks those bastards have been robbing me. I'm pretty sure they are Webster's boys, even though fines seem to be quite belligerent lately. I'll have that incompetent Lackwood Hart put some bowmen on the belvederes and parapets, just to be sure. He better double the number of guards patrolling the streets as well. I do not pay him to be lazy. The situation in Lower Locks is good, however. Nothing out of the ordinary to report. 8-20-33. Blimey! I just discovered a gambling den on my own turf. This cannot continue. Hart is more incompetent than I thought, and I think Burrows would be a far better burgomaster than Hart is, even if his connections to this Larlock Society, or whatever it's called, trouble me. Not that I dislike paganism, but he is a tad too vocal about it. Anyhow, I must stay focused and shut down that establishment. In the meantime, those rooftop breakers are still on the prowl, but we caught two of them. One of them fell to his death, the idiot. I'll have the other hanged like the dog he is. Webster wants to play? I'll show him how it's done under my rule.
Those damn tapers. Think they can outsmart me and my men,
Okay, here's a letter to Hart. Burgomaster Hart, I am most displeased to see your relative lack of commitment to our little housebreaking problem. I am not paying you nor your men to slack off. I want these remaining interlopers dealt with and sent to Gragsleft by next week. I don't care how many men you must send to scour the streets or the rooftops. I don't care if you have to do it either. I'm paying you well enough to do your job, and you obviously don't. If any of Stonemarker's noble household suffer one more burglary, I'm afraid you'll have an unfortunate accident in the nearby river pretty soon. One of my underlings is more than capable to take over your job should this incident occur. Lord Monsegur. Alright, next I want to head into the safe. Gotta use the safe key to do that.
Ah, this is what I'm looking for.
So that. That completes the main objective, to steal the opal. And we wanna leave the safe key on the carpet, and we want to head out here. Okay, I left the safe key there because for Supreme you are required to return all items. And if you pick something off a pocket, which we did, we have to return it to the patrol route. So he walks along the carpet so we can leave it on the carpet. Now there's one more piece of loot. It's hanging from underneath the chandelier. And we cannot get it from his balcony.
Tappers. Think they can outsmart me and my men, huh? Webster should know better than to defy me on my own.
So there's a couple of things that we have to worry about here. First and foremost, of course, we have to worry about Monsegur and his patrols. But also that archer that we saw is stationed up here for a little bit, then heads downstairs and comes back up after being there for a little bit. So we have to grab that diamond from the second piece of fencing here. That black metal fence. But we can't mantle up the fence without making an awful lot of noise. That's just not possible. So we have to shoot a rope arrow first, right above the fence, climb the rope, then grab the rope, and therefore land softly on top of the fence, and then we can lean in for the for the diamond. But we have to do that while avoiding both the archer and the warden.
Too much bread. Never, twas nothing.
Excuse me? He just gave me a first alert.
What was that noise?
Ah, who are you?
I'm just seeing what. How on earth did that happen? I didn't.
Show yourself.
Hmm. Can't go out now and get the diamond because he's stationed on his balcony. I have to wait so that there's an opening for us to do it without him being there. There it was again.
Hello? Show yourself. I'll find you soon.
Come back
enough.
Out here, you tapper!
I just don't understand. I don't see how that can be a first alert to anything I did. He didn't never gave a first alert earlier, so maybe that's just a part of his idle chatter. Yeah, there's nothing I could have done here. I'm in the dark. I'm not alerting him in any way. Is he maybe alerting to the loot being gone or something like that? No. Gives the same alert too. It's not like there's a variation in the type of alert, so there's nothing I did here. I obviously didn't alert him. He didn't give any remark. So I don't know what that is. I still consider Supreme intact here. So let me rather get back to my job, which is taking this diamond.
Something there.
You're a pincushion now, Taffer!
So suddenly he just stopped giving alerts, it seems like. Which is what I don't like. Don't like that at all. But I mean, I didn't alert him, so. Oops. Okay, so I gotta stop. I just can't get that remark off my mind. It's a settling remark. He didn't give the first alert, but he gave the settling remark that they give after being first alerted. But I never heard the first alert. There wasn't a first alert. He just randomly out of the blue gave a settling remark. Sometimes, because I know that this guy has new audio, like newly recorded audio that is not found in any other guard. Sometimes those audio remarks are also a part of their idle chatter, which may be what's going on here, I'm not sure. But he for sure never gave me a first alert, so I'm good. I just have to keep telling myself that anyway. Now I want to go in and grab the diamond.
What I see.
So there he gives it again right there. So it's a regular thing. Something that is pre-scripted. It's not my doing.
Too much brandy tonight. Whatever, 'twas nothing.
Shoot it up here. There we go. Easy peasy. No first alerts, and the fact that he said it again just confirms that that's a regular piece of audio that is played, just like coughing or whistling or anything like that. Good. So now the entire manor is done, bar the loot in the ballroom that we have to take on our way out, which also is another area that's a little bit tricky. Not as tricky as this, but... There we go. Excellent. In order to get back down here, what I do, anyway, is I shoot a rope arrow here, then I drop down onto it, and then grab it. And then we go close the secret panel. And then I wait here for that guard to appear again. I was thinking maybe that was a settling remark from him noticing that the loot was missing on his desk, but he didn't make it all every time, so that can't be it. real save here. And set up. Okay, so we gotta wait for this guard to come around again. I love this music right here. This is from Song of the Caverns, I believe. Brilliant. That's probably my third favorite mission from Thief Gold. I have the sword and Break from Crag's Cleft Prison as my top two from Thief Gold. And then Song of the Caverns is a third. My third. What I think is the third best mission. There we go. It's not easy to find these perfect shadows in the corners of this room, but you can get them. Yeah, so I definitely have the sword number one. And then I have Break from Crag's Cleft number two. And then I have Song of the Caverns number three. And my fourth has got to be Return to the Cathedral. Beyond that, I'm not... Oops. Beyond that, I think those four are in a league of their own in that game. The rest of them are not bad.
What was that noise?
By any stretch, but... the reason why I'm talking suddenly about Thief Gold missions is because this mission reminds me of Thief Gold. There's very few modern missions actually do. Most of them are, graphically speaking, and in terms of customized AI and scripts, way beyond, on a technical level anyway, what Thief Gold was. There. So that was two gold vases and a silver flute, total 3318, which is exactly where we're supposed to be. The next stretch is going to be a little difficult. We have to make it down to the southeast corner of the room. Oh, I was just about to save there. I'm happy I didn't. I know that a lot of players have Assassins as one of their favorite missions from Thief Gold. I don't really care too much for Assassins. I don't know, I think it's too basic. It's a little boring, it's way too easy, I think, but to each their own. Bone Horde is also a very good mission, but it's not, in my mind, in the same league as the others that I mentioned. Man. I'm creep crouch and then tapping the run key. To do that very quickly in order to make it to the other end here.
No. Who's there?
Oh, that was way too early.
What I see there.
When he turns, I can't run anymore. I have to strafe for a few moments and then keep on running when he's farther away. There's a few seconds to spare, so it's not that difficult. I love the rain sounds on the windows. That's not something I've seen in any other missions. That's great. The use of sound in this mission is absolutely fantastic. Everything is absolutely fantastic in this mission.
I thought I saw some.
Except for my ghosting abilities right now. It's late at night. The beer that I talked about is the only one I've had, so that's not what's impacting my ghosting abilities, if that's what you're thinking. So if that's what you were thinking, shame on you. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. To get back up here, best method I've found is to lean out and simply rope arrow up. I want to wait for that archer though to come back. We don't have too much left. We have Burrows Estate, Usher Palace, and Felton Manor. That's really all we have to worry about. And those are not too difficult. Where is that archer? Has he disappeared? There he is. Good. I was worried he was stuck for a second. I haven't seen a single guard stuck in version 1.22 of New Dark, by the way. That might just be coincidental, but that's the truth. So hopefully that will continue. You can drop down and mantle up the ledge down there. Who knows how Garrett does it, but you can. I just have to wait for that archer one more time. So let's have a couple of cheeses. What a thief. If you guys hear my cat, he's here around my legs. Apologize for the noise. She just wants to be cuddled. Okay, I want to shoot a rope arrow in here now. Then I want to wait again until that archer comes back, and we can travel across the chain. That's Burrows Estate up there. There we go. Make another reel save there. Perfect. This is going good. Now, there's another windowsill on the far corner of this tower that I want to reach again when the archer is gone. He covers the territory well. Windowsill, we have two stacks of silver coins and one stack of gold coins. That was a terrible jump. Catching onto ropes is still a problem for Garrett, even after all these years. Total 33.67. Into this window. Okay. In here, we have a rope arrow, a vase, hammer, total 35.42, and a letter. Here's what I managed to swipe from the warehouse across Cloister Lane. Don't tell anyone, but I suspect that old crow Damien of being aware of something. He always gives me weird looks when I do my rounds, and he always happens to be in the vicinity when I hide stuff. This is why I decided to drop the loot here rather than in our usual hidey hole. This way he shan't have any proof we've been stealing from the hammers. I can probably find a peddler or two ready to buy the stuff, but in the meantime, keep these two items secure. Gregory. P.S. Don't waste the money on fox tossing and ale like last time. So the warehouse across Cloister Lane. That's not an area we can get to, and the place he's talking about is probably... the sewer hideout for the thieves. Now, I'm going to show you something. I'm going to reload because I got caught. And
quiet now.
It's an area that we don't need to get into, but I just want to show you the items there anyway.
I thought I saw something.
Yeah, sure you did.
No, it was nothing, I guess.
Let's go ahead and blackjack him. You can pick the lock on this door, which I don't like to do. So that's why I'm not going in there at all. But there's no loot, there's only a fire arrow, there's a mine, there's a healing potion. If you head down this ladder, you can get to the vents that I showed you in the ceiling of the barracks area earlier. So that's how you can tie this entire mission together if you want to. You can pretty much take the entire mission by way of the rooftops. Oops. Man. There we go. Now we can mantle up the generator. We can head over here. Drop down on this side. Now we are back. This is the starting area down here. So we have covered all of the north and northwest area. We only have the southeast quadrant left. We're now right here. And we're going to clean Burrows Estate. We have a little bit left of that. Then we're going to hit Usher Palace and do Felton Manor in that order. Just beautiful scenery in this mission. Oh! Well, at least we could enjoy it on our way down. Sorry about that. This is a mission that, even though this will be my third time through it, and even though I've Supreme Ghosted it, or, yeah, I have, and I've done that twice now, including this recording, I'm still guaranteed going to replay this mission in not too long. That's just a testament to the quality of the mission. Thought we could do that without making noise. If you crouch first, you can.
What's that?
Oh, he sees me going down the stairs through the railing. That's a nice little trick. I didn't know about that, actually.
Huh? I heard that.
There's nothing of value upstairs. That we want to head down here. Under the stairs is another readable. It was last day whence the good lord watched from his high windows and said a fellow named Findlay best gonna die for stealings. B's gonna die for stealings. But Findlay said he's never was a thiefsy, and he never stealed anything, he said. The crowds didn't listen, and Findlay found himself hanging by the necky. And they all clapped their filthy hands, and the poor thieves he died for nothings, while the good lord smiled from his high windows to the crowds below. If only the crowds knew ye what's the good lord does from his nightly chambers, he bees hanging by the necky the same as Findlay. Interesting. Okay, down here there are a few things. Two gold goblets, total 35.92. Third goblet here on the windowsill, 36.17. And then
this will make a nice little bonus.
Ritual paw, which is the pagan relic. So we checked off that objective. Bottle of wine. This is the house key that we don't need. Hide in this corner. The house key just opens the door, which leads back up to the garden, but we can leave the way we came in. This is a copy of the local newspaper. No, it's not. That's not found here. That's found in a Lancashire Palace. This is a letter from Monsegur. Burrows, you are my lieutenant, and this is why I'm trusting you with this. You will deliver a message to the local Hamrite priory on the morrow, telling them that you have found an undercover gambling den in the vicinity. I've discovered that this pathetic joke of a nobleman, Bafford, is running this establishment on my own territory, under the guise of a candle shop. Ramirez is audacious, but I think he already owned it back when De Waal was in charge. Anyhow, I can't risk any breaches like this, and I'm sure Ramirez will be delighted to see the hammers raiding his clientele. That'll teach him, Monsegur. So, I guess this says Hammer Priory, then. Okay. That explains it. Not familiar with that term. That's it from here, so we can leave. I guess really that we have to wait until he comes back down. Okay, back outside. Let's head down here. Careful of that guard. Here we can save. And I always have a problem avoiding that noise. I remember that from last time. Grab one green vase right here, worth 50, I think. Yeah. 37.17. There's another vase. And there's one where the guard is coming from right now. Oops.
I know you're up.
Yeah, he heard that little step that I made. Sometimes it's a problem if they go directly to hunt mode. Because they don't give a first alert, so you're not aware that they actually know you're there. Suddenly, you might quick save, and then suddenly they're just hunting for you. There we go.
What's going on over there?
There's a ring on the table worth 100, total 39.17. And here is the City Tribune. Lord Felton found dead. The Honorable Lord Felton, owner of the eponymous manor in Stonemarket, was found dead in his chambers yesterday by his wife. Lieutenant O'Malley was dispatched to solve the case and told the Tribune Lord Felton had no known enemies and was loved by the people of Stonemarket, so murder is not in our main theory. It looks like he died in his sleep of natural causes. One woman working for the Felton family told the Tribune that she suspects a pagan conspiracy. Pagan assassins, poisoning, or old age? More on page 6. Fence Sebastian Dahlquist arrested. Dahlquist, a known fence of despicable reputation, was arrested on Tuesday evening. Tuesday evening by the order of the Hammer, and was transferred to Cragsleft Prison. Dahlquist is known for hiring assassins to serve as thieves, and for employing street urchins to spy on the common folk and steal from market stalls. High Priest Laurentius told the Tribune, "This miscreant shall now look upon the Master Builder and implore his mercy, though thieves, pawns, and murderers shall not escape his judgment, and in his infinite wisdom the Builder shall cast the sinner to the earth." More on page 9. This is just so cool. Just a couple of pages from the local newspaper. Fantastic. So, I assume this is Lord Usher. We can mantle out the window. And drop down here carefully. Yep. No alerts there. And I want to jump over here and mantle up. Which is possible. More than possible. Just gotta see if I can remember how. That is definitely not how you do it. Good. There we go. Okay. The last window here on the right, we can climb up. And then there is a couple of things here. Actually place the rope on the opposite side. A little bit easier to grab these things. A purse worth 25, total 39.42. Oh, I didn't know there was a plate on the back side there. And then there is a letter, a strange letter. "Greetings, my good friend. I hope you had a good time in Shalebridge last week. I have a good one for you, if you care to listen and if you don't tear this letter like last time. I was in that seedy tavern near Darkside the other day, and there was an old sellsword drinking his weight in ale. He started to talk about some sort of treasure that's reputed to be somewhere within Stonemarket, and that his last master tried to get it for years. Needless to say, that poor bugger died without ever getting that treasure, no matter how many sneaks he hired to do the job. I asked the grumpy old taffer to give me some more information, but he was too drunk to give me precise directions. He just said something I obviously won't be telling you, but that was enough to tell me where to search. Well, my friend, I'm going to get this treasure, and you will gnash your teeth in frustration when I return with it and drink to your good health from my golden cups. Rasky. So that's the thief that we found dead in the Keeper Grotto. Okay. We should jump over to the last window now and enter that. Easier said than done. Wow. I'm not landing on top of it enough to actually get a foothold, but not far enough away to actually be able to mantle. I got it. Okay. We gotta pass through this building to get to Felton Manor, but there's a guard here as well. Shouldn't see me, but I didn't crouch. We gotta head out this window. This is a little bit more difficult because there's a guard on the other side and there's a guard underneath me. I think that guard on the other side can see me over here. I think it's too far. But I think I'm gonna wait just to be sure. So this is the Hammer Priory. Same deal as before. Once we're here, though, we can actually drop down onto the little...
Someone behind me?
Let's just wait for him to leave. I think that's easier. It's late in the mission. I'm getting impatient, as always. That was not what I intended to do at all. I intended to lean. There. We're safe from both sides. Right here. Actually move along this pipe right now, because the other guard goes inside for a bit.
saw something. Seems peaceful enough now.
Okay.
I'm not sure if that archer saw me. Definitely didn't see me there because I wasn't even in the yellow. Okay, when he comes out, we want to go in.
Hey, what was that?
Oh, what did he do there? Did he make a turn? We can wait. Wait over here then. Does make a turn. Strange. This door will take us to the room where the ruby is, Lord Felton's ruby that we have to get. But we can't get it if we go through that door. Instead, we gotta head through this vent. Can't hear the vent open if he's all the way over by this wall, but he wasn't. So now we're out on the rafters in the room. This is the door that I talked about. And there's only one thing of interest, and that is the last objective, steal the late Lord Felton's ruby. And that is the red ruby you can see down on the table on the left here. This is very tricky to get. This room is all tile, and it's pretty much no shadows except for on top of the rafters. Of course, we can't get it from up here. So, we're not allowed to use any moss arrows for Supreme Ghost. So that is not an option. But we can use rope arrows. So what I do want to do is shoot a rope arrow.
Someone make it.
Without pulling the drawstring back fully. That actually makes the rope...
I saw something.
Let's wait for this guard to kind of be out of the way a little bit. So I want to place a rope arrow as close to the wall as I possibly can without wasting it.
Hello?
So it's got to be a little bit less than that, too. Maybe that'll do it. I'm not sure. I have my doubts, actually. It should be higher up. No, I got to shoot it higher up. Because I got to be able to get down there and back up quickly.
Sir? Sir?
Mm-hmm. Let's try that then. We can always retrieve the rope again and try again if we need to. Here, let's see.
You won't need that anymore.
There we go. It's pretty easy. But now the problem is getting back up to the rafter.
You won't need that anymore.
That's how we do that. Grab the rope, Lord Felton's ruby. Checks off the last objective. Now all we need to do is grab the remaining pieces of loot and get back to the starting point. Excellent. We have to head all the way down to the bottom floor though, because there's another piece of loot down there. Well, there's actually two pieces of loot here. And then we have to head down that vent. It's a gold vase worth 100, total 40, 42. I want to follow this guard all the way in here. If I can manage to do that. It's going to be close.
Something move there?
Yeah, that's going to be close. This is better. There's just a single candlestick in here, but it's still loot. Go 50, total 40.92. We should be good here. Not 100%, but 98.6. There's a note here on the door. Attention guards, the lady is in a state of dismay following the death of our most esteemed lord. She is not to be disturbed, and I have decided to increase the rounds just in case. No slacking off, especially with all these thefts lately. Keep sharp. Captain Gallagher. Okay, let's head down this vent then. A couple of things to the basement, and then we'll head back up. Here is another gold candlestick, total 41.42, and a letter that fell down the drain. My most esteemed lady, thanks for bargaining with your humble servant. As you are aware, I am certain the contents of that bottle are dangerous and should not fall into careless hands. Remember, one drop will plunge a man into a deep sleep. 3 drops will make a man sick for a week. 10 drops will slay a man outright. It is not my custom to ask what purpose my concoction will serve, so you can rest assured of my utmost discretion on the matter. I remain at your disposal should you have any questions. Or if you want to purchase something from my fine establishment again, Ralph Downer, Apothecary, Stone Market. Okay, so there we have it. Proof that the lady was responsible for Lord Felton's demise. This door will take you out to the canal, pretty close to the Hammer Sanctuary, or the Hammer Cathedral Temple building. But it's pickable, and that's why I didn't enter that way. Okay, now we can head all the way back up to the top floor again. Gotta head back over to towards Usher Palace anyway. I don't think that... I was worried when I played this last time whether the hammer could see me or not down there on the street, but I don't think there's any chance of him seeing me up here. I mean, granted, when your light gem is red, you can get spotted from pretty extreme distances, but not this extreme. Okay, there we are. Not much left now. Almost done with this. Okay. Okay. Dropping down onto the window here is a good way of doing it. Then we want to head over back to that ledge. Nice little jump, as such. This is how we left Usher's Palace, but now we want to head... we're heading east now, yeah. On this windowsill right here, you have a bottle of wine and a goblet, total 42.17. Then head around here. Drop to this ledge, all the way back in the corner, there's a ladder. Another beautifully crafted area, this, I think. Sort of enclosed, but interesting, nonetheless. If you drop onto here and then jump over to this side, you can drop all the way here, and I just wanted to get away from the view of that guard. So now we're in the far southeastern area. The only area we haven't been to so far. Gosh, come on. Come on, come on, come on. There we are. So this is the butcher shop. We've got to pick the lock on the door here. Our third picked lock should be. In here we have our last piece of loot, a purse worth 23, total 42.40. That's max loot for Supreme. We got three deer legs, which isn't of any value in Thief Gold. They can't regain health like in Thief 2, and a diary. Damn these shortages. I don't like having my stock delayed like that. I have to make a living. This will force me to return to my old meatballs, but my short time in Blackbrook showed me my customers did not like my recipe and my business collapsed. Oh well. What do you know? Looks like I got a tidy profit out of my meatballs after all. All the other butchers in store market are jealous of my sudden success. People walk over each other to taste my meatballs. Good thing only I know the recipe. Well, if you look in here, maybe you can get a hint of what his recipe is all about. They're not meatballs, I would like to try anyway. Okay, now we just have to leave. We have to head up this alley to get back to the starting location. Flip this switch. Flip it again on your way out. So that we have it closed. We can sneak up here. Run back to the starting location, and that should end the mission. Yep. We should be good. Perfect. So that was a successful Supreme run, and also a successful Ghost run of Endless Rain. Brilliant mission. Total time, 1 hour, 44 minutes, 55 seconds. Found 4240 loot out of 400, or 4500. We had to skip 260 loot in the Keeper Grotto, because you have to use a holy water vial to get down there, and that's not allowed for Supreme rules. So that's what prevents perfect Supreme Ghost from being possible. We picked four pockets, we picked three purses, and one key, the safe key from Monsegur, and the fifth one was Nate's grocery store key, which we didn't even need. We picked three locks, we picked the door to the apothecary, the entrance to the weaponsmiths, which led to the Keeper basement, and we picked just now the butcher's shop entrance. Backstab 0, knockout 0, damage dealt 0, damage taken 0, healing taken 0, innocents killed none, and others killed 0. So that's it. Thank you guys for joining me in this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Next, I'm definitely going to finish the Black Frog, and then we'll see what comes after that. Probably some more fan missions. I will probably, I've said that to a couple of players already, that I probably will do the original missions of both Thief Gold and Thief 2 eventually, but not yet. I have a few more fan missions that I want to do first. But that's for another time. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Have a good night, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.